With the warmer than normal summer weather we're having, more people are heading to local beaches. A program in East Pierce County aims to keep swimmers of all ages safe this summer season. Joining me today is Ryan Boyle. He is with the Bonnie Lake Police Department. Tell me about the Swimsafe program.
The Swimsafe program is a great program. It takes a lot of work by a lot of people to make this program a success. This program was born out of a tragedy from 2001 to 2011 where we had a drowning each one of those years. In 2012, we had three drownings, and a coalition of nine different agencies came together, said we'd had enough, and they put this coalition together calling it Swimsafe. And from that point on, we've been the sponsor of water safety throughout all of Pierce County and the leading agency in Pierce County.
And I understand the coalition has taken this into the classrooms. Tell me about that.
They have. What we've done is we've brought this to the classrooms, and we've now participated in four different school districts, Sumner, White River, Derringer, and Carbonado. And what we do is we now educate the kids in the aspects of water safety. And this year we've reached over 7,000 kids and showing them how important it is to wear their life vests, how important it is to have a buddy out there while they're in the water, how important it is to know their limits and their surroundings. Is it deep water? Is it cold? Is there a current? To have their parents be notified of where they're going, to tell their parents and have a line of sight. These are all things we kind of go through with the kids, and we hope that they take away this when the end of the school year is there and they have the whole summer. We also offer the whole family life vests if they should choose to purchase it, and this year we sold 100 life vests throughout these kids. So that's 100 more life vests that we have out there with the kids to protect them while they're swimming this summer.
And I know that Lake Taps just is finally at recreational levels. Sure. And people are getting ready to head out there. What are some things people should be thinking about along
well,
those lines?
Well, this is an unusual year. This is the first time in a long time that the lake has been drawn down to where it was, and it now is at recreational level, like you said. The things that have happened, though, is these logs and the debris at the bottom of the lake have since dried out because the lake was so low, and now they're floating. So we're asking people to watch for the debris, the logs out there, anything out there that might cause an obstruction for your boating experience. Also, we're trying to get them people to understand that the lake has just been recently filled, and the river that's supplying that is the White River, and it's flowing at about 55 degrees. Surface water of the lake is fairly warm, but just below the thermal layer, it's going to be about 55 degrees. So we're asking people to take due caution while they're going out there in the lake this year.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming in today. Great tips.
You're welcome.